Good Sunday evening, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austin Onick with a quick look at what's going on with your forecast, current weather information across the Mid-South, and a look at a few other things going on out there that you might be interested in. A lot of people want to know a little bit more about what's happening with the fires out west as the fire season continues to grow and getting, again, the possibility of even more potential problems for travelers out that direction. We'll take a look at that coming up here in just a little bit. If you're planning travel to the Gulf of Mexico, or the Caribbean, the Bahamas, the East Coast, the Gulf Coast states, any place like that, stick around because we'll have a complete look at what's going on with the tropics as, again, the National Hurricane Center keeps an eye on those areas for the development of storms as we are now officially, again, into hurricane season. We have had one storm so far, Alberto, just a couple of weeks ago, and it looks like it could be another busy season out there. Catch the entire forecast, again, available here at WREG.com/weather if you'd like to know a little bit more about what's going on throughout the evening or throughout the rest of the upcoming week as well. If you've got any weather reports out there, let's see where you are, city and state, and then also give us a weather report with temperature. If you have a rain gauge, the shower that got anything out there today, if you got a wind speed, wind direction, temperature information, stuff like that, let's do some citizen science and take a look and see what the amateur meteorology report is around the area. Can't stick around for the whole forecast on weather overtime. That's great. All you have to do is, again, drop to the bottom of the page. The red bar down here is scrolling along. That's, again, the forecast. You can also catch, again, the 7 to 10-day forecast here. And, of course, we'll have more details coming up on News Channel 3 at 10, so stick around for more on that. Sunset and temperatures will be dropping in the next couple of hours. Not much, but at least we'll get some relief out there anyway. Temperatures heading back into the mid to upper 70s by the time we get into around very early tomorrow morning. A few areas might make their way into the lower 70s, but mainly mid 70s is going to be the main thing. Mostly clear overnight, a few clouds more possible into tomorrow. We're about to get another surge of moisture coming up from the Gulf of Mexico. We're going to be seeing more chances of showers and thunderstorms. A little bit better tomorrow, a lot better on Tuesday and Wednesday. We'll take a look at that forecast coming up here in just a little bit. Diana Stacy, 92 in Blytheville, no rainfall to report. Marion, Arkansas, just down the road, 87 degrees, no rain. Christy Simmons, thank you very much for that one. Rancho Cucamonga, California, a little bit outside of our viewing area, but welcome nonetheless. Sunshine and windy. Doris Morgan, and I'm just betting probably some lower humidity values out that direction as well. So thank you very much out there. Lamar, Mississippi, HOT, capital letters. Kimberly Fryer, thank you very much for that report out there, and welcome to everybody else who's tuning in. Ole Miss campus, some sunset light reflected in the trees above the Grove and the area right back around Vaught-Hemingway Stadium in Oxford, Mississippi for tonight. Right at the moment of sunset from Germantown City Hall, the water towers north of Germantown High School, and looking back toward around Poplar Pike and Germantown in that area for tonight. Temperatures in the mid to upper 80s with winds out of the south and transporting some more moisture in. It's still not that humid out there. Yes, it is humid, but with these numbers, it's not quite enough to get a lot of showers and thunderstorms going, so we don't see a lot of activity there. And from Shelby Farms Park, a little bit of jogging, strolling, bike riding, some frisbee tossing around the area there, and again, a few clouds out there as sun begins to head its way down over the southwest horizon, and a beautiful view with the sun just setting over West Memphis, Arkansas, into and around the area, looking over the Mississippi River, Big River Crossing. A lot of people out there today for catching a stroll or a jog. Few sprinkles trying to pop up across portions of the area earlier today, but beyond that, we don't have much of anything going on. Excuse me a second. Looks like our hand tracker system is having trouble once again, and there we go. A lot of thunderstorms back over areas around central Alabama, but really just not that much going on where we are in the Mid-South area. We've got a ridge of high pressure sticking around the area, and that's keeping the showers and thunderstorms kind of at bay. It's going to be doing a very good job of keeping things quiet for us for the rest of the evening. Still pretty toasty out there. Live real-time WeatherNet 3 showing mid to upper 80s across much of the area. Paulette Morrow, 86, and clear in New Bern, Tennessee. Marco Davis, hate the summer heat, waiting on fall weather. You've got just about 100 days to go until fall starts, roughly somewhere in there, and about 10 until summer actually begins. So thank you very much for that vote of confidence for autumn coming on through there. Hot in Fraser, Cynthia Mitchell Bradbury, thank you very much. 82 feels like 85 in Olive Branch, Sherry Massey, thank you very much for that one. A few clouds, 84 in Eureka Springs, Mississippi. Thank you, April Hentz, for that one. Coming up in the next several hours as we get into around tomorrow, we see again that potential of some more showers and thunderstorms possible into around the morning, but much of what we're going to be looking for is going to be afternoon and evening coming up. So right around News Channel 3 daybreak, back in the lower to mid-70s, and that's about as cool as it gets. Through the rest of the afternoon, we're going to start to get that push of warm, moist air coming up from the Gulf, and that means more fuel and more instability for those showers and thunderstorms. That ridge that's been across the area kind of keeping the possibility of showers and thunderstorms to a minimum, giving us high pressure down toward the ground, stabilizing things. That's going to be gone tomorrow, so I'd expect more chances of showers and thunderstorms. So vacation Bible school, that golf game you've got, kids swimming lessons, stuff like that. Definitely want to keep an eye out for anything involving thunderstorms developing tomorrow. And that's going to be the forecast right on in throughout the course of the rest of the next several days. So this forecast is going to seem very familiar into, again, the next few days after we get into the rest of the week. So looking at temperatures again, back in the 90s for highs, isolated chances of showers and thunderstorms here, better chances of showers and thunderstorms into and around the area toward about Tuesday and into Wednesday or so. This is where we're going to be seeing, again, the best possibility of showers and thunderstorms more widespread across the Mid-South. That's going to be the highest potential we have throughout the next several days. Now, toward next weekend, things start to kind of quiet down a little bit anyway. We start to get closer to about that 10% level or less of showers and thunderstorms, but still possible around and through Saturday and Sunday. Again, for Flag Day, review the rules of displaying the American flag. Make certain that you have it displayed properly. And if it's inclement weather, may want to go ahead and package it up and bring it back indoors again to make certain you're displaying it. But again, make sure to get your American flags out and display them coming up on Flag Day. Now, through the rest of the forecast, again, we start to drop the numbers a bit, not by much. Temperatures, again, by this area of the forecast, 10 days out, these numbers are more suggestions than anything else, but we may see, again, that potential of the numbers dropping closer to normal in the upper 80s by next Tuesday, but that's going to be about as all we get into and around the area there. Brownsville, clear and 85. My display's jumping around on me here. Diane Sangster, thank you very much. 88, clear in Gosnell. Great motorcycle weather. Ron Hutto, thank you very much for that one. Dee Dee in Walnut, getting home from Southwind. Thank you very much for that. Pleasant night in Nesbitt. Kay Wharton, thank you very much for dropping on through. Deborah Gray, yes, remembering the snow we had earlier this year. Yeah, it was nice while it lasted anyway, but at least we got a little bit of snowfall out there. Celia Horton Lair, 89.6. That's a very specific temperature. Thank you very much from Henderson. Thank you for dropping on by there. Now, taking a quick look into the tropics, again, we'd have tropical air mass in place across the southeast United States. You can see those showers and thunderstorms developing there. Down into around the western areas of the Caribbean, right into and around the area close to about here, we may see, and Cuba right on in through there, Jamaica back on over toward the Hispaniola area. This is where we may see a development of a new storm taking place somewhere in about the next 7 to 10 days or so. These storms sometimes take a while to develop, but here's the thing that's been going on in the last few days. A lot of what we call faux, F-A-U-X, or as in fake or wannabe forecasters, have been doing a spectacular job of looking at the computer models that are hundreds of hours out instead of stuff that gets really close where we can get to be more accuracy. And they have been screaming their heads off about the fact that this is going to develop and move back this direction in the next several days, possibly as a storm system that could affect right around the Houston area. Now, is that possible? Absolutely. Is it a possibility that we could see another type of storm like Hurricane Katrina? Yes, absolutely. Is it a guarantee that this storm is going to develop into something like Hurricane Harvey and directly strike the Houston area like last time? No guarantee of that whatsoever. It is way, way, way too far in the future to start throwing around forecasts like that. I've gotten several questions on social media. Is this real? Should my family evacuate? How much insurance should I plan on taking out? Things like that. Here's the thing about those forecasts. Yes, any time at this time of the year, it is possible to get a storm like that that could threaten anything along the coast, back into the East Coast states, the Caribbean, the Gulf, all those places. But here's the thing. It is, again, way too far out in advance. The closer you get in the forecast, the more we're going to be able to tell you about how to respond if you need to evacuate, things like that. People who are posting that information online saying that 300-400 hours out in the future you need to evacuate and just shy of panic, those people are causing a lot of problems for people like us who try to keep you informed about things. Please review what you share on social media and don't go just forcing along that information and saying, "Oh, look what I heard." Okay, that's not safe. That's not responsible. As my wife calls them, the sparkly snow maps of doom that happen every single winter that show that like Florida is going to get about 2 to 5 feet of snow. Things like that are just thrown together by people who want them to happen. Wish casting is what it's called. It's not necessarily a guarantee. So please keep it tuned to News Channel 3 and the National Hurricane Center. This is where we get our official forecast from, and we give you an idea as to what may or may not be happening. And as of right now, for the next 2 to 5 days, the National Hurricane Center does not see anything developing of note. It's possible, it's just not likely enough to show in their current forecast. So keep it tuned to us and we'll keep you updated on that just to be on the safe side. All right, earlier this evening we promised you a look at wildfires out west. They're starting to catch on a lot more thanks to power lines, some transmission errors out there, some electricity that sparked off some debris, lightning strikes, campfires, all the usual reason. And there is a ton of information online that you can get from a lot of different locations. This one from InciWeb or Incident Web that shows and tracks how many of the largest wildfires are going on across the western United States. This is a very good place to go to for more information. Now, not much of anything major is happening over here where we are. It usually gets into the drier period of time where you get those grass fires started off anywhere between Texas and southern Canada. Most of the activity right now is out west. If you would like to take a look at this stuff and get an idea as to what's going on, there is a great place to go to. It's called the National Interagency Fire Center. So if you're traveling out west for camping or business or whatever, and you want to see what's going on out that direction, including evacuation notices or what the situation is with back burns and things of that nature, all you have to do is go to NIFC, National Interagency Fire Center, NIFC.gov, and that'll be a great place to start to get more information about what's going on, where, who you can contact for information, which direction the fires are going. They even have a YouTube channel. That's pretty cool to think about that so they can get more information about how they do what they do and how you can get more information that way. I'll post more information about this link-wise throughout the course of the next few days and keep it tuned to News Channel 3 again for the latest information on that. I'll have details on the rest of the forecast again coming up on Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3 throughout the rest of what's left of the weekend. And be sure to join me tomorrow morning bright and early starting at 8 a.m. with Bob and Josh on Talkback Live. I'll have a complete forecast from 8 to 10 a.m. as they talk about sports and all sorts of information coming in from the area in and around the Tigers and, of course, the FedEx St. Jude Golf Tournament. A lot of stuff going on there. Big weekend with sports happening. And, of course, I'll take a look at weather where the troops are coming up here in just about 20 minutes on my Facebook, Periscope, and Twitter page so you can find out a little bit more about what it looks like out there for your friends, loved ones, and relatives serving in the United States military. Got weather pictures or anything else you'd like to feature? We'd love to know more about them. Tweet them to me at aonic_WREG3 or email them to me at austin.aonic@WREG.com. We'd love to have you along for the ride or post them on Instagram or again on my Facebook page. And we'd love to see a little bit more about what you're seeing out there so we can show them to everybody else. Don't have any new submissions tonight, so don't have any pictures to show you, but we'd love to have you along for the ride to show that off. We'll have more on the possible late edition of News Channel 3 at 10. The Tony Awards are going on tonight, so they may run over by a little bit. In the meantime, Kristen Holloway will have all the day's news. Mike Sadie has all the day's sports information. And, of course, yours truly with your updated weather forecast that will be coming up tonight on News Channel 3 at 10. Thanks to everybody for joining us. Thanks for all the weather reports around the area. Keep it tuned to News Channel 3 on air and online for the latest information and at WREG.com.